I don't argue. I just hit that chick with a bottle. I don't fight. I don't argue. I just hit that chick with a bottle.
Yo, you know what it is. It's Thursday Night Girl Fight. I'm at all good, baby. We in Tulsa, Oklahoma, sold out. It's the last girl fight before Slammiversary.
Let's get this party started.
What's up, PWW Universe? Welcome to a girl fight. I'm Lance Hogwood, baby. We start your night off with a champion versus champion match and put some respect on it. It's the PWW Universal Champion, the two-time Universal Champion. And you know she is living the dream right now, being able to go into Slammiversary as the top cat, the head of the table, Babe Brooks, to defend the Universal Championship at Slammiversary. And that match is TBD, baby. Get you some, Tulsa. Get you some. Put some respect on a PWW Universe. It's the PWW World Cruiserweight Champion, Brittany Grace.
And
as you know, Brittany Grace is the new Cruiserweight Champion, and she is going into Slammiversary as that. No match yet signed for that one, but it will get signed and it will be on the line. It's TBD, baby. And right now she's taking on the Universal Champion, Babe Brooks. We got a fight brewing. This should be a good one right here. Babe Brooks, the top cat, head of the table, taking on the Cruiserweight Champion. If you have not yet seen the card for Slammiversary Saturday night, and what a move already on Brittany Grace, Babe Brooks right on the attack. Go check it out. It got signed. It's what the people wanted. It's Kelly Kelly of the NWO teaming up with Marcella Perez, and they are going in the steel cage against the LWO cartel.
And now, what a bulldog by the Cruiserweight champ, Brittany Grace, as she is in control of the Universal Champion right now. And then she flies off the rope with
the whiff.
And a big forearm by Babe Brooks, and she's going to the top rope, looking to fly. And fly she does, right on top of Brittany Grace. And the ref gonna get a little exercise before he
goes for the 1-2-3. He must have not ate his Wheaties this morning. And there's a kick to the back by the Universal Champion, and she is in control of this match. Fireworks are sure to be popping tonight. It's the last girl fight before a Slammiversary. It's just weird that it's still quiet right now. Somebody's got to have something up their sleeve as Babe Brooks gets sent to the outside by Brittany Grace. And you can win by a 10 count, but nobody wants to win that way. As Brittany Grace now with a laydown DDT to the champ right on that mat on the outside. And that has got to freaking hurt. And the Cruiserweight Champion in full control of this match. Neither one of these ladies know who their opponent is, but both of them know they have to defend their title come Sunday night. That card will be put out probably by tomorrow. And Babe Brooks now with the kicks, and it's gonna be a pump handle slam. Good night, Brittany Grace, the pile driver, and Grace kicks out. And how in the world did she freaking kick out of that? And now she swings a Brittany Grace into the turnbuckle. We have got one half of the tag team champions, Janice Mason, taking on Violet Church of the Ministry. That is coming up next. You don't want to miss it. And Bay Brooks sending her up for the dropkick to the back of the head. And Grace down. And Grace moved out of the way of the shooting star and gonna blow Bay Brooks a little kiss. And Brooks sends her into the turnbuckle. And now she's gonna set her up for the dropkick to the back of the head, number two. And Brittany Grace could be out after that. And no, she kicks out of the cover. And Babe Brooks right back to the attack with the punches to the freaking face. And this is why she is the two-time Universal Champion. You go sleepy weepy now, Brittany Grace. Good win for Babe Brooks with some momentum going into Slammiversary. God help us all. I think I spoke this into existence. It's the freaking Ministry Countdown. And Babe Brooks, look out. It's Lauren Baldwin. She could be cashing in. And I don't think it's a cash in. She's staying at the ramp, running her mouth, and Babe Brooks ain't gonna take it, and we are gonna have us a tussle going into the commercial break. I'm Lance Hardwood, baby. We got one half of the tag champs and more Ministry coming up next. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back. The Ministry had some kind of plan tonight, and it is working out to perfection, as there are no entrances for this one. Janice Mason in the ring called out Violet Church, and Violet Church is here, and we got a fight before the fight. And the ref gonna get out there to break it up, but that don't matter. Janice Mason pushes him out of the way, and a punch to the jaw of Church, and here we go. They're both in the ring now, and the bell is gonna ring, and we gotta fight. And look at Mason. Big knockout punch to Violet Church, and Mason going top rope. One half of the tag team champions. And what an arm drag by Mason. And Church is down. She could be hurt. And here's a cover by the ref. One. And Church kicks out. Coming up next, the heavyweight champion Casey Turner doing some one-on-one against Taryn Nolan, and there's a big blow to the side of the head by Mason, and Church popped right back up, and no matter to Mason as she takes her down. And there's the standing shooting star, gonna give her another one, and the knees were up by Church right into the ribs of Janice Mason. And now Church in full control clothesline from hell. And Mason is down, and now gonna stretch that arm out. Oh my God, the Ministry is in full force. The Ministry is on it. Here's the cover by Church, and Mason kicks out. Don't forget, the Hooligans will be having to defend their tag titles in the biggest tag team championship match in PWW so far. But right now, she's got her hands full with the Ministry's Violet Church. I could have grabbed. And Mason is down. And Violet Church setting her up. You go sleepy weepy into the turnbuckle, Janice Mason. And that made Church stumble a little. She could have hurt herself. But nonetheless, has Janice Mason up and delivers Sweet Dreams. The cover by Church. And that's a quick win for the Ministry. And this is what I get for opening my damn mouth about nothing happening here on a Girl Fight. we got the heavyweight champ coming up next, taking on that Terry Nolan. I'm at Hardwood, baby. It's Girl Fight. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back. Put some respect on it, PWW Universe is the PWW World Heavyweight Champion, Casey Turner.
The following contest is scheduled for
much respect to Casey Turner, as he has been one hell of a champion.
Two-time
PWW World Heavyweight Champion, and she's taking that into the Slammiversary. Her match is still TBD, baby, but that's all right, because she's got a fight tonight with the Beast, Terry Nolan. Get you some, Tulsa, Oklahoma. Get you some. If I was Casey Turner, I'd keep my eye open for Evelyn Mercer, no doubt about it. And here comes the Beast, Terry Nolan. Casey Turner, the heavyweight champion, has her hands a full tonight. A little pre-fight before her big match at Slammiversary, but it is going to be no pushover. I guarantee you that one. As she should keep one eye open for Evelyn Mercer, as I started something by running my mouth, and the ministry has gotten control of Girl Fight tonight, and that is scary, as it's the last one going into Slammiversary. Right now it's Terry Nolan and Casey Turner, one-on-one. It's Girl Fight. Get you some, Tulsa, Oklahoma. Get you some. And this should be a good fight right here, as Nolan right on the attack to the champ and giving her some knees to the ribs, and already in full control of this match. And look at the athleticism. Who would have thunk that Terry Nolan had it in her, as she is covering the champ already. And Casey Turner kicks out. You wonder if Casey Turner is worrying about Evelyn Mercer right now, as the ministry's plan of taking over Girl Fight has gone 100% right so far. Coming up next, a tag team match, an unusual tag team match, and it could have been set up by Pretty Boy Lee himself, as LA is teaming up with the newest member of the Hooligans, and you know, they do not like each other. So they are taking on Cassidy Cashman and the partner of her choosing. And that's coming up next. And then it's the main event. It's a triple threat falls count anywhere. The international champion, AA, in that match against Carmelo of Valentine and VZ, baby. I love me some Victoria Zinc.
Right now, it's a sit-down jawbreaker by the heavyweight champion, and she is in full control of this match right now. And she is pulling Nolan away from the ropes, giving her a kick to the ribs of the standing shooting star, and here is the cover. Nolan kicks out. much to the dismay of the heavyweight champion, and she is taking it out on the referee. And now she's gonna finish Nolan off, make sure of it, and look at the elbows to the side of the face of the champion, and Nolan gets out of that, and now clothesline from hell, and the champion's down, and the champion could be hurt, and now it's night-night time, and Nolan with the cover. That's a good win tonight on the heavyweight, and how in the world did Casey Turner kick out of that? I have never seen anybody kick out of Nolan's move, and now a shooting star from the ropes, and Nolan has the chance number tonight. I think Evelyn Mercer is in the back of Casey Turner's brain as there's the knees to the chest, and now some dancing and showboating by Taryn Nolan. And now Nolan's setting her up. It's sleepy, weepy time. Heavyweight champion, and that's a good win for Taryn Nolan. And that is not Nolan's music. That is another Ministry Countdown. Casey Turner, gets your ass out of the ring. It's Evelyn Mercer. We have got to take a break. We'll be back with more. I'm Lance Hardwood. Baby, don't go nowhere. We'll be right back.